defensive team, number two in the conference, but both like to get up and down the court. Both love transition. When you got Jays and Birds, could be a high-flying game.
And we have some of the best players in the league, including none other than one of the National Player of the Year candidates in Doug McDermott.
Doug McDermott went off for 44 already once this year. Second leading scorer in the nation, just a sophomore. Watch his footwork on offense. Watch his ability to use both hands. Just outstanding at 24.5. And you've got to find a defensive player, Jackie Carmichael. He will guard the post player, whether it's McDermott or Echenique. He also is the leading scorer and the leading rebounder for the Redbirds.
Our starting lineup sponsored by Slucare, and these two teams featuring some terrific lineups. Look at the visiting Jays with Young and Maniga, the guards, Gibbs and McDermott, one of the best pairs in the country right now, and Echenique down low for the Jays. For the Redbirds, Brown and Moore, the guards, Wilkins and Ike, and Jackie Carmichael at forward for Illinois State. Tonight's starting lineups, a presentation of SLU Cares, orthopedic sports medicine specialist at SLU Hospital, who can help keep you in the game. Our State Farm keys to the game.
Well, when you look at the Blue Jays going on the road in front of 10,000 people tonight, they've got to have some calmness, especially early. And they have a capable two-point guards, whether it's Young or Gibbs out there to do it, chasing the threes. They got to make sure the Redbirds don't get hot. The Redbirds, number 14 in the country in making threes per game. Now you look at the Redbirds, Illinois State, they got to get Moore, and I'm talking Nick Moore transition. He loves to get it up and down the court. A freshman, you will love watching him. He loves to play the game. And then D up on the blocks. Can't let Echenique and McDermott get down on the blocks first. If they do, it's all over.
The State Farm keys to the game for auto, home, life, and banking. Get to a better state. Find an agent or get a quote at statefarm.com. And here is tonight's series history brought to you by Coventry Healthcare. And you can see Illinois State leading this all-time series 40-26, but Creighton has won the last two meetings, including that 75-59 victory last season.
Boy, and you talk about towns and universities excited. Creighton and Omaha going nuts over the Blue Jays. And now with that last second shot, Carmichael, Jackie Carmichael made a three-shot banker to beat Evansville with 2 seconds left to go on a full court length of pass. His first career three. And now the Redbirds in Bloomington Normal excited about the Birds and Tim Jankovic.
This place is crowded here in Normal, Illinois. They are ready for some basketball. Illinois State has not beaten a ranked opponent since 1987, when they beat
the Iowa Hawkeyes in Oklahoma City in a tournament I actually did. And the next night, Oklahoma and Billy Tubbs took Illinois State out. They had a great team, the Sooners, that year.
And we're underway with Illinois State winning the tip. And Nick Moore, the freshman, controlling the action.
I'll tell you, Tom, this is what we love. College basketball, a sold-out arena, games mean something, conference play.
Right away, an open shot for Ike and missed.
Ike's really improved his offense. As a freshman, he really allowed other people to take the senior position. Now, as even a sophomore, he's showing leadership.
Here is Grant Gibbs. He has been so important to Doug McDermott's success, and McDermott double-teamed and traveled.
And you saw Wilkins at 6'9", take Doug McDermott. Wilkins, an excellent defensive player. Earlier this year, he took Jake Cook here at home and held him to zero when they played the Panthers. Just watch the matchups, especially at the post play. You see Carmichael, Echenique, two big bodies.
Tries to throw it inside to Carmichael and goes out of bounds. It'll stay underneath.
Well, we expected a high-scoring game. But on the other side of that, both these teams pay attention to that defensive end because they know both teams have terrific offensive players. Here's the push.
The steal by Echenique. Gibbs finds the open man. And it goes down. Maniga.
I'm going to tell Tom, we got to watch Gibbs, number 10. Terrific vision. 22 years old, just a junior. played at Lynmar Marion High School in Iowa, went to Gonzaga, had several injuries, and transferred to Creighton. And they said last year, you could see how good he was going to be and make a difference in this team.
Carmichael with the deuce on the other end. Greg McDermott telling us before the game that one of the best attributes of Gibbs is that he does not get rattled, especially in a game like this. McDermott, the turnaround, won't fall for him.
Terrific job again by Wilkins, pushing McDermott just a little bit further off that base. Like we said, got to fight for the block space.
Moore with an opening, hits the shot.
And what a game he had at Wichita, huh? How about that second half?
Outstanding. Nick Moore coming off a career best 23 points, 20 in the second half against Wichita State, as Creighton scores on the other end.
Yeah, a nice pick and roll. Both teams like to use that high post pick. Echenique goes to the rim as Nick Moore really got picked off. Easy opportunity.
Brown with the drive for Illinois State.
And that's the guy Coach McDermott said I worry about most, because he's a guy that can go off. He's had games where he's been held in single figures and late again.
Echenique with the jam. Back and forth they go with the lead changes, Matt.
Well, now we're getting that offensive game we talked about.
Three ball goes down for Tyler Brown.
That's what we said. Coach McDermott really concerned about Tyler Brown going off, and he has with two quick buckets.
Gibbs to McDermott. Oh, what a move off the glass. Doug McDermott, a National Player of the Year candidate. You see some of the skills there.
Well, the thing that Doug does so well is work totally all the time at the offensive end. He's always moving, always trying to get position, always trying to get an angle. And as a defensive player, you can't let up during that 35 seconds.
Open shot for Gibbs. Moore tries one. Wilkins grabbed the rebound and a foul.
Well, that's the thing you'll get with Nick Moore. He feels it. In other words, he made a basket earlier as a freshman. Sometimes he'll take some quick shots, and maybe you'd say, hey, let's pull him back. But again, he's open. He's got all kinds of confidence. Terrific job by a freshman in running this team. But he still has growth, especially in understanding time, score, especially the shot clock.
Illinois State, with those three-point attempts already, has attempted 369 three-pointers this season.
Well, they almost shoot half their field goals, Tom, from the three-point range, 47%. Nationally, it's about 31%. And Creighton's right at that, right at 32. So a high, high number of three-point attempts by Illinois. Therefore, they get a lot of long offensive rebounds.
Ikey.
Whoa.
This is everything there. So grabbing it is Artino.
You know it's a bad shot when it hits the floor and nobody had to block out.
McDermott draws some attention, gets it back. And they whistle him for the travel. He doesn't like the call.
He picked up that right foot as he picked up the ball. And he spun, and therefore had the travel call. McDermott, 2 turnovers, 9-9.
The MVC on ESPN3 is brought to you by State Farm for auto, home, life, and banking. Get to a better state. By Emerson, the proud presenting partner of the Larry Bird Trophy. Emerson, consider it solved. The farmer-owned Prairie Farms family of dairies. Prairie Farms, Highland and Roberts. Farm fresh quality from our family to yours. By Cardinal Glennon Children's Medical Center, where our love for kids just keeps on growing. And by the Return the Favor Charity Stripe campaign. Visit mbcsports.com/charitystripe to return the favor to our military. We've had four lead changes already as Creighton and Illinois State locked up at 9 apiece with Mac McCausland. I'm Tom Ackerman.
Well, you see Grant Gibbs, number 10. When he starts on the wing, he sees McDermott working for position. He knows he can't beat his man, so he does a reverse pivot. As he reverse pivot, he has a great angle to get into McDermott. Now the up and under move by number 3, second leading scorer in the country, Gibbs McDermott. Terrific together.
Gibbs, the transfer from Gonzaga, always looking to make the better pass and does right there. Look at this by Wilkins.
Illinois State likes to do what they call slip a screen. You start to come up, set a screen, and then you dive to the basket, looking for the ball all the way. They cleared out the side, no help, and a layup.
First bucket in the paint for Illinois State.
Altino the same way. Slip that screen.
Get that one to go.
Another native Iowan, just a freshman redshirt, runs the court extremely well.
Stolen away, loose ball. Artino slides, but he was on the line.
Again, aggressive defense in the gaps. Josh Jones. And then Artino making the move. Watch and see if Illinois State again comes up with a high post pick. They got Treloff in the game, and he is a big tree.
They want to use that size with Echenique. And Treloff should see some minutes. Brown with a high arcing shot, no good. Gets a rebound. Treloff can't get it to fall.
We've got Carmichael and Echenique out right now. We got Artino and Treloff in there, the backups.
McDermott in the lane. Crowd wants 3 seconds.
What a great job. I mean a great job by Wilkins. Staying down, not going for any of the spin fakes or moves by McDermott. Now he gets a cheap foul. He had help behind him. You gotta understand, there's help behind you. Wilkins, you can tell already a little tired chasing McDermott.
To be a great player, you have to be able to find seams in the defense and get yourself in position to make a play. Aren't many players in the country doing that better than McDermott?
No, he just has a terrific feel, but to go along with it, he's got two or three teammates that really understand where he's going to be, and that's led by Grant Gibbs, and where he wants the ball. Now McDermott may pop out a little bit because he's had trouble on the inside game. He does shoot at over 50% from threes.
Artino knocks one down from just inside the three-point line.
Thing amazing to me with Creighton, every player has a plus assist to turnover ratio except the bigs.
Cousin runs into trouble. Carmichael there from the baseline.
A little quick shot, no offensive rebound in position at all.
Gibbs with it. The kick out. Creighton with a big three-pointer there from Chapman.
Now Austin Chapman, one of those players, when called upon, has responded. Coach McDermott said he'd like to even find him more minutes.
Foul called underneath on Artino, trying to make a play.
And we're going to have a hockey line change, but you see the tap in the air by Rotina. Right there, Will needs to just stay in position. Carmichael's going to catch it about 10 feet away from the basket. He's not going to go and shoot it probably anyway.
And Janike comes back into the game for Creighton. And a host of others. Ethan Rogge, watch him. Big man can shoot.
And takes nothing but threes. In the scouting report, you see 34, you stay on him at the line.
Three-pointer knocked down by Brian Allen, the sophomore.
I'll tell you, he is the energized bunny squared. He has high, high energy. former football player at the University of Minnesota, great athlete out of St. Louis, now playing basketball at Illinois State.
Great personality. Teammates love him. He's always chirping, having fun, just enjoying the game. And an offensive foul as Allen was standing in the way.
Tell you, practice today, he was nothing but smiles, getting his teammates revved up for this game. It was like a football practice.
All tied up in Normal. Our Missouri Valley Conference standings, a presentation of Purina Dog Chow. Long live your dog. You can see this matchup, a tie for first place. Creighton, Wichita State, Missouri State, and Illinois State with a win can even things up with the Jays.
They certainly can. Going around the conference right now, Missouri State at Northern Iowa. I had just 1 point early in that second half, but Missouri State looking for another road win. They had a big one, of course, at Creighton, and Bradley getting blown away down at Wichita. Maybe a bit of an upset. Drake up 6 points over Evansville.
And Southern Illinois leading Indiana State by three early in the second half. Here we are tied between two of the top teams in a steal as Josh Jones goes in for the lay-in.
Josh Jones told us today at the shoot-around, this is where he got going last year. He'd come in here 0 for 17 in threes and then made four threes here in Red Bull Arena, so he likes playing here.
Allen with the feed to Brown, miss.
Ike, a nice keep alive.
Long three.
Another keep alive.
Ike gets it. Keep Brown across the court, Cousin.
Cousin says, not my turn, I'll wait.
They love to shoot it. Really exciting guards on this Illinois State team, too. It's been a big improvement for Tim Jankovic's team. Brown.
Well, is he a nice offensive player? Marshalltown Junior College. You know, he is a scorer and a shooter. He's just not just a slasher. Terrific three-point range. Shoots it at 47% there.
Deflected to Carmichael. Still no offensive rebounds for Creighton. Four for Illinois State.
Yeah, I love Ike. That's three times in just one trip. He has kept the ball alive.
Brown draws a triple team, and they swing it to Ike.
Nice screen by Carmichael. I'd like to see the Redbirds go in low, though, and challenge the defensive interior. What's he do? Three.
You leave
him. He does one thing.
Leave him open. Roggy hits the three.
Roggy in the Valley has taken 22 shots. Now 21 of them have been threes.
That one sweet by Allen.
We saw him get a really inaugural start down at Southern Illinois. Came in and not really scored a lot or played a lot and just went off with three threes. Oh, nice play.
Hard, blocked away.
Got a finish.
Cousin on the other end.
Anthony Cousin.
Back and forth they go at Redbird Arena. The crowd loving it on this Friday night.
That's your Nike about as low as you can go.
Carmichael gets his hand in there on the feed to Echenique. First one on Carmichael.
The shooter, here it comes again. This is what you see out of Drake. A lot of rotation, two, three, and four players at a time. They are going to go a little deeper than the Redbirds.
Gibbs and McDermott in there.
They like to get McDermott the ball on that second pass right here. Oh, nice drive.
Gibbs.
Holy cow, was that smooth.
Roggy with the finish.
He used McDermott as a decoy. The defense went to McDermott. Gibbs just a little lay down dime.
Carmichael on Roggy with the basket.
Antonio Young has been the point guard for Creighton. But when Gibbs is here, it really becomes a point forward, and they'll move Young to a wing a lot of times.
He finds McDermott wide open for the three.
That's just a mental error by Carmichael. He's not comfortable going out to the free throw line. He'd rather guard somebody on the post. He was 15 feet away. McDermott, 56% from threes, 62 from the field. You just don't find that.
Carmichael. Illinois State locks it up at 24.
Tom, this game is fun. This is Valley offensive basketball.
There's really been a spark offensively in the Valley as Young goes in for the basket.
You've got to know he's left-handed, and not just that he's a left-hander. He will go left-handed 90% of the time.
Creighton by two as we see Carmichael on the other end for Illinois State. Tonight's Prairie Farms MVC Scholar Athlete of the Game is Illinois State's Chad Hinshaw, junior outfielder from Bloomington, Illinois. Hinshaw batted 244 with 10 doubles, 22 runs batted in, and 31 stolen bases in 2011. An honorable mention MVC Scholar Athlete selection. Hinshaw has a 3.55 cumulative grade point average in construction management, posting an 8-game hitting streak and collecting 11 multi-hit games in 2011. The farmer-owned Prairie Farms family of dairies. Prairie Farms, Highland and Roberts, farm fresh quality from our family to yours.
When they say cumulative average, they mean add them all up, right?
That's right.
Freshman, sophomore, junior, senior.
How about this? Illinois State, as a team, 3.15 cumulative GPA for all student athletes. That's an all-time record at the school.
Well, you look at this game, what you had right there, Greg McDermott, potentially the player of the year in the country and in this game. You've also got on his team Gibbs, who could be the newcomer of the year, and you got Nick Moore, the freshman of the year, all in this game.
Young with the miss, Allen's able to grab it. We've had 10 lead changes in this game already, and 5 ties.
You really see a 4-out, 1-in by the Redbirds. 4 perimeter shooters, Carmichael facing up, no offensive rebounds. In fact, offensive rebounds are really missing from the Blue Jays stat column. They're at 0.
Gibbs finds an opening and kicks it out for 3, Manigault.
He's an energy guy, and also, when you look at him, you got to understand he's going to shoot threes.
Carmichael back the other way.
That's better because Carmichael, quicker of foot, he can get by Echenique. Facing up and doing a fadeaway isn't doing the Redbirds any good.
Creighton 5 of 6 from three-point range. McDermott with the left hand.
That's where he's so good. You know, you watch Gerald Sullinger. I've had a chance to see him live a couple times. He uses primarily his right hand. McDermott is equally adept at right or left-handed.
Brown, it's a better shot, missed it, and Echenique gets it.
Redbirds have got to start playing some defense because Creighton right now is shooting over 80% in this first half.
Gibbs and McDermott playing catch here. Gibbs with the miss. Moore pulls up. Five-point lead for Creighton.
Thomas said 80%, 70%. And right there, they're making it higher. Oh!
Missing the jam, Echenique.
Wide open.
Here's a little bit from the faithful here.
Carmichael setting that pick.
Allen.
Nice. I love his game. Think if, he gets an offseason, because he wants to play football here at Illinois State as well. I'll tell you, he's been terrific for this basketball team.
Very good football and basketball player in high school in the St. Louis suburb of Maplewood.
Nice pass by Gibbs, that bounce pass. He'll reset.
Manigault tries one.
Oh my goodness.
3-point basket.
Another three for Creighton.
And it is a horse game for Creighton. You'd like to say Illinois State's playing defense, but there's no question Creighton is getting great looks and they have not missed it.
6 of 8 from beyond the arc. Wilkins.
Yeah, back down the little guy. Smart play, took your time.
Right back ahead. To a 4-point game.
Oh, steal.
Allen all alone. They'll call goaltending on that one.
What you love is Manigault as an energy guy. He's a shooter, but he also hustled back on defense, sprinting.
Allen comes off the floor, waves to the crowd, gets them involved in a standing ovation.
Right now, Illinois State really is a 7-person rotation. Got Treloff back in there, that makes the 8th man. But it's been basically Cousins and Bryant coming off the bench. Nick Moore got a thick body. He can guard other point guards with that thickness.
Wilkins and McDermott battling away from the basket. Now McDermott works on him, draws 3 defenders. The miss by Jones.
The push by Moore.
Moore all the way. Got it!
Does he love it? Do the Redbird fans love it? Nick Moore, freshman from Indiana, showing you speed.
The 5'9 freshman with the basket and the foul. We're all tied up at Redbird Arena. When Niles Media Group takes its television cameras on the road in the valley, it considers these hotel properties its home away from home. Please call these hotels or visit the websites of these properties when following your favorite team away from home. Here in Normal, Illinois, we're tied up at 34. Creighton, the 21st ranked team in the nation, playing at Illinois State, getting all it can handle. You want some offense? How about 51 field goals attempted? Mac, that's a shot every 19 seconds.
Well, both these coaches love offense, and obviously Coach Jankovic was a point guard. But today, you know, he's a Rhodes Scholar candidate. So we asked him if he knew what trichodicophobia was. And he said, what? He says, you can't say that on TV.
We just did.
Trichodicophobia, it's Friday the 13th. It's fear of number 13. So we asked him if he had any superstitions. And he said, no, not really. He says, you know, some routines work better than others. And then he goes, well, except about 4 years ago, Cyrus Eldridge had us like 17-0. I drove the same way, got the same candy bar, same cup of coffee, wore the same tie. He says, I'm not superstitious.
See, I think they get in routines and don't realize it, but they do. Yep. They are superstitious as Moore completes the 3-point play with the free throw and Illinois State with the lead. Gibbs. And that shot by Artino missed everything, but Creighton able to get it back, and McDermott with the turnaround.
He just worked so hard to get himself low around the basket, and he keeps working his feet to seal off people. And then when you go to sleep, he just steps out and makes a soft little jumper.
That's the thing about him. He's not a perimeter player. He's working the tough points inside as Treloff gets it knocked away by Gibbs.
Well, not a lot of free throws in this game.
34,
and not a lot of fouls. Right now you've got Redbirds with 3 and the Jays with 4. This is where they'd like to give Brown a shot too, number 1.
Moore with the inbounds pass. Wilkins.
Okay, he has not made a 3. Since Dirt was invented. It has been a long time for Wilkins. 3 of his last 25.
Second foul on Carmichael. He looks to the bench. And Tim Jankovic will take him out of the game. Two fouls for Carmichael. Probably won't see him again this half.
And now the Redbirds go small. We're getting Cousins, so you got Cousins, Brown, and Moore. And just two bigs. But you still have Wilkins on McDermott, and Echenique's not in there. So Rodney's another perimeter player for the Jays. And in this game, we have seen one senior, and that's Young, number 30. Other than that, everybody's back.
Gibbs' shot goes down.
Basket number 10, Grant Gibbs.
Creighton up by three.
He just lets the game come to him. You know, he's not going to overpower you with quickness. He's had two knee operations, a shoulder operation. But he is elite smart. Talk to Dave Tears about he'd like to get into college coaching.
Cousin along three.
If you just have a feeling for this game, your feeling would be that the Blue Jays are further ahead. And yet somehow, some way, Illinois State has battled back in, got a couple steals, and kept himself right in this game.
Gibbs takes a long shot and it won't go. McDermott gets the rebound with one hand and was fouled on that attempt.
Burger foul 13, John Wilkins, his second.
Creighton with a three-point lead on Illinois State. We're at Doug Collins Court at Redbird Arena in Normal, Illinois. This Valley matchup between the first-place team, Creighton, tied with two other teams for first in the conference against the second-place and somewhat surprising Redbirds. Continuing to battle back, McDermott. Knocks down the shot, and a five-point lead now for Creighton as we near the final minute of this first half. Moore with it for Illinois State. Brown will take a three. Fighting for it is Gibbs and Brown, and a foul is called.
Well, once against Brown. Once again, it's Gibbs being an important part of this team. And now if you look at this, you could get a two for one. A lot of college teams just don't do that. I think part of it is they don't practice it enough. You know, in the NBA, there's four quarters, so they get to practice it four times a game.
Since the free throw by Moore coming out of the timeout, Illinois State hasn't scored. This is a 6-0 run by Creighton, matching its biggest lead. Manigaw misses on that one. And Moore with it back the other way for the Redbirds. Finds Cousin. That one misses everything by Upshaw.
Tough spot for him. He hadn't played in this first half. Have to take a wide open look.
McDermott working on Eakey, and they call travel. That's the third travel violation against McDermott in this game.
Just a little hop when he turned around. He really didn't go anywhere. But right now, Illinois State is going to do the use it or lose it timeout.
And Greg McDermott is hot. He's very upset about the travel call. He's working on the officials. Let's take a look as McDermott just a little shuffle right there. It's the right call.
It was interesting. Coach McDermott out there talking to the official, and at the very end they both smiled at each other. And you know, we really haven't talked about Greg McDermott and Doug McDermott are father son. Sometimes you take that for granted. You know, it does give you some interesting things that can happen on the team. We talked to a couple of the players, and they said, in all honesty, it has never been an issue. I think it helps when the son scores 25 a game.
He's having a tremendous season.
They say it's really kind of funny in practice when Coach McDermott starts to yell at son McDermott.
So Illinois State down by five. Shot clock off. And working to cut into this lead before the break. Moore gets instruction from Jankovic, his coach. Allen with it. Now to Brown. Moore with a three, short. Out of bounds, it'll go off Creighton and stay with Illinois State with 2.8 on the clock.
Now you can bring Carmichael in or your offensive people because they're not gonna have to play any defense.
Echenique and Carmichael check into the game together.
So the bulk comes in, here come the defensive tackles. Huh?
Trying to get one shot and Carmichael will set up on the right elbow. Keep an eye on him. They throw it to the backcourt. Brown with a shot at the buzzer. No. And Creighton goes into the locker room with a 5-point lead at Illinois State. Terrific matchup early on through one half here in the Valley.
Tim.
Mac McCausland with Tim Jankovic.
Coach, offensive game right now. The Redbirds have given up almost 65% in that first half. What do you need to do defensively?
A guard, yeah. Yeah, you're going to give up 40 in the half, but, you know, we're playing fine offensively. But they're a tough team to stop, and we're not, you know, we've had some issues. Obviously, McDermott made some really good plays, but we haven't guarded the ball screens very well. We got to do a lot better job of that.
Good luck, Tim. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mac McCausland and Tim Jankovic. Tonight's St. Charles Convention and Visitors Bureau plans for the second half. Our chat with the coaches brought to you by St. Charles, Missouri Convention and Visitors Bureau. When making plans to attend the 2012 State Farm MBC Women's Basketball Championship, go to www.historicstcharles.com or call 800-366-2427. At the half, Creighton leads Illinois State 40-35. Terrific matchup in the Valley. Glad you're with us. The MVC on ESPN3. Let's take a look at our halftime stats. A production of the DoubleTree by Hilton, the official hotel, the Missouri Valley Conference in Normal. Call 309-664-6446 or visit DoubleTree.com to book your hotel rooms on your next trip to Normal. See those three-point field goals. That's a big story of the game so far. Creighton shooting it very well, and the turnovers 5-2, 5 on Creighton. Now let's check in with Greg McDermott. It's tonight's St. Charles Convention and Visitors Bureau plans for the second half.
Coach McDermott, first half, you got off to a great start, good shooting percentage. What do you need to do here in the second half?
Well, I think if we continue to take good shots, we'll be fine on the offensive end, but we've been a little flat-footed defensively, a little bit slow to recover on some of our help, and that's got to improve.
Any particular thing you want to try and do?
I don't think we have to change anything. I think our plan was good. We backed off a little of the aggressiveness on the ball screen, and I think we have to continue to mix that up.
All right, Coach Mack, thank you.
Our chat with the coach is brought to you by the St. Charles, Missouri Convention and Visitors Bureau. When making plans to attend the 2012 State Farm MVC Women's Basketball Championship, go to www.historicstcharles.com or call 800-366-2427. Creighton by five as we open the second half. Illinois State hasn't scored in the final 3:52 of the first half. The Redbirds were held scoreless. That was the free throw by Moore as a foul is called, and that's the third on Carmichael, just like that.
Now that's not a cerebral basketball play. Early on, getting the flow of the game, Gibbs, you've got to understand who you're guarding. Gibbs isn't going to be a scorer. He's not going to drive it to the rim. He's going to set other people up, so he's not even a threat to Carmichael. Just show, back off, and go guard Echenique, because he was the guy that they're going to go to.
So 10 seconds into the second half, Carmichael picks up his third foul. That is an issue. Watch that. He stays in the game.
Look out. They went right back at Echenique to see if he could get four on him.
Moore.
Smart play by Gibbs.
Moore with the steal. Ike. Echenique grabs the board.
And as you said, Illinois State not very accurate in the last 4 minutes. That time, Ike very flat with his shot, very flat.
Gibbs finds an open Young. Manigault back to Gibbs. Wilkins on McDermott. Double team and short. Wilkins doing a nice job guarding McDermott on the baseline.
And again, push him off the blocks. The winner to the blocks seems to get the best of it. When McDermott can get right on that black square, he scores.
Wilkins on the other end, a miss.
Well, we said it's been a tough situation for him from the arc. Another miss. But defensively, he's been very good on McDermott.
Gibbs' pass into Echenique is knocked away. That one's missed by Brown. Echenique grabs it. Brown nearly came up with it. Manigault hits the three.
What a terrific find he is. At 50% from the arc. And in this game, continuing that. That gives him 4 of 5.
Jahens Manigault, the sophomore from Ottawa.
Neither of these teams have locked down defensive players.
Inside. Bucket good by Ike.
Ike, nice high pass. When you look at a post, you want to lob it or bounce pass it. You don't want to throw it right at their chest. It gives a lot of hands a lot of opportunities, and that time Gibbs couldn't go up with Ike.
Whistle and a foul inside. They will call that on Wilkins, actually on the perimeter. And that's his third.
So nothing good happening in the first 2.5 minutes for the Redbirds. And you got Wilkins and Carmichael, the two big bigs, and athletic bigs with 3 fouls.
Wilkins stays in the game. Ike and Carmichael take a seat. Treloff in the game. And then you have Bryant Allen, who was a real spark in that first half. Draghi with the miss. That time he had someone in his face, see?
Well, and it was Treloff that came out. He may be feel a little uncomfortable out there. Ah, Treloff with a little turn.
Treloff.
I like that. He's going to be a very good big-time player. Treloff with a bump, big-time, elbow to Draghi. Nothing called. A little more physical this half.
Big player at 6'10", 255. Draghi left open and drains it.
Draghi says, back at you.
Good battle between those two. It's a 7-point game. Brown can't get it to fall. McDermott holds it up.
Well, he just dives right to the basket. Wilkins could have picked up a fourth there.
A little opening and McDermott takes advantage. And a timeout called as Creighton has stretched the lead to 9. It's 48-39 in favor of the Blue Jays. Tonight's date in MVC history is brought to you by the VFW Foundation. January 13th, 1968, Creighton's Bob Portman, who had 32 points and 13 rebounds, hit 13 of 13 free throw attempts in an 88-86 victory over Oklahoma City. The VFW Foundation and the Missouri Valley Conference ask you to participate in the Return the Favor Charity Stripe campaign. Visit nvcsports.com/charitystripe to find out how you can return the favor to our military members and their families. Creighton's lead 9 right now, 48-39 over Illinois State. And how about this? Illinois State has missed 13 consecutive three-pointers, now 2 of 19 for the game.
And that's from a team that team-wise, they shoot 38%, make 9 a game, 14th in the country. Over at UNI, Cedar Falls, the Panthers get Missouri State 61-60. That could have been a heck of a game.
Well, we have seen some great games already in the Valley, and we're just in mid-January. Wilkins on McDermott. Gets a tough basket.
And the battle of the stick men in there.
Wilkins playing with three fouls.
Boy, a nice pivot move again. Slipping by McDermott. He just keeps moving. You watch number three. Now he's down on the block. Trying to set himself. He'll clear out, see if he can find something. Rogge. Goodbye.
Quick pass by Gibbs to find him, and Gibbs yells out after that assist. Rogge splashes one.
You know, when coaches talk or fans talk about IQ players, it isn't so much how you play, it's understanding how everybody else plays. And you know Rogge's going to float to the baseline or to the wing. So when you come across, if you start to see white jerseys come to you, all you do is flip it to Rogge.
That one goes in and out for Rogge.
That was a heat check, by the way.
Allen will try one. Allen, the last Illinois State player to make a three back midway through the first half, connects there to cut it to seven.
It's almost a set shot, but it goes in. Nobody asked how. Moore trying to find the hot guy.
Young Whoa. Answering on the other end.
Little Marcus Haynes. He's going to try and take his guy off the dribble if he can.
Allen working on Manigaud, a foul called. A 9-point lead for Creighton at the 14-23 mark in Normal, Illinois. Tonight's Missouri Valley Conference scores and schedules, a presentation of Casey's General Store, and we have some finals, a convenience store, and a whole lot more. And how about the Northern Iowa win over Missouri State by one, and Southern Illinois knocking off Indiana State.
Yeah, that Southern Illinois team have finally gotten all their players back. They really struggled to get a squad of much more than about seven, and a surprise there on the road, Drake Bulldogs without Van Deest, who's going to redshirt now, a 9-point win. And Wichita State just TCB taking care of business against the Bradley Braves and new coach Gino Ford.
So a busy night in the Valley. Our Casey's General Stores scores. And here it's Creighton by 9, 53-44 over Illinois State as we wrap up the action tonight, and still 14 minutes left in what was a high-scoring affair for a while. And things started to slow down a little bit, but not for the Blue Jays.
Part of it slowing down because Illinois State can't make shots. How about this? Now you've got Ryan Allen going to the line. Up until now, both teams combined for two free throws at the 14-minute mark. He is going to double the free throws in this game.
Allen makes them both.
I expect him to really come up and get pressure. He loves to play defense. Extremely quick. See if he can bother Young so that Creighton can't get into their set.
Only Illinois State player in double figures as they loft one in to Echenique. Allen with 14 points to lead all scorers. Young inside. Echenique takes it down and was able to come up with it. Back to Young.
Boy, when you're trying to come back, you cannot give up two offensive rebounds on one possession.
They throw it inside and they say Treloff fouled Echenique.
Foul 42, Jordan Treloff is first.
Treloff bumping.
Out of bounds to Creighton.
Both these teams love to try and score off that inbounds. You've got McDermott out of there now, so you would have to take a lot of motion. See if you can get Rogge a three.
Jones shot long. Echenique out to Gibbs.
Treloff has got to be more active. Bump. Get Echenique off there.
Gibbs from the baseline.
Treloff just not experienced enough or strong enough to keep Echenique away.
Allen miss. And Echenique as Gibbs hits the floor hard.
You know, that's a stat that will never show up. He didn't get credit for a steal, a rebound.
That's all foul on Echenique underneath. Got tied up down low. So Echenique with the foul. And Illinois State with the ball down nine. Gibbs, how about, you were talking about stats and that little play there. How about eight assists for Gibbs to go along with 4 points and four rebounds?
You know, and there's nothing flashy about it. You know, this court is referred to as Doug Collins, who is a real deft passer. But you look at Grant Gibbs, it's just get the ball to the open man. You know who can shoot it. You give it to them. Keep it away from those who can't shoot. Here he is actually playing the point. You know, a little fake. Defenses really have to stay at home on those three-point shooters.
Chance to take a double-digit lead. Gibbs in with the left hand, a sweet move.
And the reason he can do that is his length. I mean, Grant Gibbs is 6'4", maybe 6'5". He's not going to blow by anybody, but he uses his angles to the rim very well.
Carmichael on Echenique, and the defense there, but Illinois State coming up with the loose ball. Moore just can't get the shots to go down.
Carmichael's down.
Carmichael hurt. Rogge with an open three, and Creighton goes up by 14 as Carmichael in a lot of pain.
And Rogge with his fourth three in this game. And I don't know if Carmichael got hit in the chest or the head, but it certainly looks like a upper, yes, not a knee or an ankle, certainly.
Talking to him now, we'll take a look after the break. Creighton by 14. Take a look at Jackie Carmichael on the Illinois State bench as the Illinois State training staff, medical staff, takes a look at him. Creighton with the lead. Let's see if we can see what happened to Carmichael.
Carmichael's at the top of the key. Shot goes. He starts to head in and gets hit, blocked out, right in the stomach chest area. Gibbs, and he goes down. So right now, the shooting percentages for Illinois State continue to be just short of terrible. 30% for 2 points for the whole game and 60% from the arc.
Emerson, proud to bring you tonight's Larry Bird Trophy update. And you can see we have a couple of candidates right here in this game. McDermott and Carmichael. Weems, one of the best players in the league. Ryan, who has been scoring like crazy, 21 a game. And Anthony James.
AJ for Northern Iowa Panthers. Probably had a pretty good game tonight. But Weems, McDermott would have to be your two leaders, I would think, at this point.
To learn more about the Larry Bird Trophy, visit mvcsports.com. Emerson, consider it solved. Illinois State trying to cut into a 14-point lead. Floater by Allen won't go.
Really not probably what you want there. I think you want to really try and see if you can get Brown going or Ike. Neither of them, since the very start of the game, have been involved in the offensive flow.
21st ranked team in the country trying to get some separation and doing just that.
You know, we talked, Tom, at the start of the game about playing with calmness. This Jay Bird team, when you really look at how the Blue Jays play, they're poised, they're calm, they have a real focus about them, what they want done, both offensively and defensively, although they have really had their way shooting-wise, terrific percentages, above 60 for the game and from the arc.
And really playing with a lot of intensity right now, kind of sensing the knockout blow here. as Young guarded by Moore at midcourt.
Etchenique and Treloff continue to go each other pretty good.
Quick shot by McDermott won't go. Ikey pulls down the board. Moore at the top of the key.
Yeah, a little short curl cut by McDermott.
Ikey, it just will not fall for Illinois State today.
He's 0 for 5 now from the arc. And he's a guy that really had improved his shooting to above 40.
How about 3 for 23 from three-point range for Illinois State?
Well, you're not going to beat very many teams. I don't care what kind of defense you play. And, of course, Coach Jankovic wanted his team to play better defense, but you got to be able to score.
Gibbs all the way in, won't fall. Etchenique, turn around, put back is good.
Etchenique from Venezuela.
Timeout called by Illinois State, and the Creighton bench is up and hooting and hollering, and Illinois State has missed its last 7 shots. Creighton capitalizing just about every time. And, you know, the turnovers, too. Creighton's turned the ball over 8 times, but Illinois State hasn't been able to capitalize on that. Just 4 points off the turnovers.
And inside, Etchenique set a little screen, then a slip. He goes right to the basket. Gibbs goes to the rim with a little floater. Etchenique with inside position. Treloff's got to fight him off that block. Bounce him out of there. Etchenique slipping down, and Treloff following the ball, letting Etchenique get inside position. Now it's all over. And you see Etchenique, and you see some pink shoes that Etchenique's got as he heads to the bench. Last year, Etchenique and the rest of the team got him when it was coaches versus cancer. The whole team had pink shoes. McDermott family, very active in that. As Coach McDermott's wife, Teresa, had cancer 6 years ago. And since the treatments, things have been very, very positive. And I think it'll be on January 28th.
On January 28th against Bradley, Creighton will have a pink out at the arena there, the Century Link Center, Omaha. Pink jerseys, pink shoes have been ordered. We're going to encourage the crowd to wear pink. Coaches versus Cancer Week in Omaha and around the country.
Yeah. I've been involved with Coach McDermott. And also Ben Jacobson at UNI with Hoops for Hope. That's been done in the state of Iowa. And Coach McDermott, you see the pink shoes there. So it isn't something where other fans maybe thought he was trying to be a bit of a showboat or a hot dog. He just wants to show his appreciation for Coach McDermott and wife Teresa.
64-47, Creighton in charge.
And I think those two words are very accurate. In charge and large right now. 17-point lead.
Jones for 3. Brown with the rebound. Illinois State long pass. Carmichael back in the game. Gets it to fall.
Nice run out by Carmichael. And that will be something Coach McDermott will shake his head about, as he talked about transition baskets being stopped, and they really have for the most part in this game. The ball kind of bounces high. Blue jerseys just look at it. Nobody back. Carmichael with a victory lap and a finish.
The old-fashioned three-point play. Try to put the finishing touches on that. Cut this lead to 14. Creighton has been in charge in this second half for certain. Carmichael can't get it to fall.
Well, there is time with the exception. You better get some turnovers. You got to get some easy baskets now. Because if you don't, as you indicated kind of earlier, Illinois State with just 6 fast break points and just 4 off those turnovers. And you can't let this man have the ball a lot, because he can get, oh, a nice trip.
Taken away by Johnny Hill. Carmichael on the other end. Lead is 13. Crowd sensing a last chance to make a run with 8:25 to go. And that one goes off the hands of Creighton. Out of bounds, it'll go to Illinois State.
And it continues to be a well-played game in terms of fouls. Just 7 called in this half. between the two teams. Illinois State with three. And the Blue Jays with four.
Johnny Hill, the freshman guard from Glendale Heights, Illinois, has the ball, gives it to Carmichael, goes in on Echenique, and a foul called on the big man, Echenique.
Right now, it's a good read by Coach Jankovic. Clear out an entire side. Let Carmichael, who's quicker than Echenique, and can take him off that dribble by himself. A couple quick dribbles, got to the rim. Got to make these, though.
Makes the first of two. Carmichael with 13 points. Make it 14. 11-point game, 64-53.
The redshirts start to stand up, get excited. See if they find McDermott.
Young in the lane and gets it to fall. Antoine Young.
Instead, at the beginning, when Antoine Young has the ball, he is left-handed. And I mean, he is strong left-handed. You got to make it go back to the right.
Creighton up by 13, 66-53 at Illinois State. Doug Collins Court at Redbird Arena. Illinois State on its home floor down by 13 to Creighton, and a chance for Antoine Young to make it 14. He'll get a free throw. Not only is Creighton making shots, but the Blue Jays have been killing Illinois State on the glass in the second half, out rebounding them 15-6.
Yeah, and you know, when you look at the Blue Jays, as we said, it looks fairly simple, but you've got to really have players that like each other, people that are really unselfish. And when you talk to Coach McDermott, he knows he's got a star offensive player in his son, but he gives all the credit to Grant Gibbs. He goes, he's all about team first, winning first, and it becomes very contagious.
Leading scorers in this game, Rogge with 14 for Creighton. Allen, that ties a career high with 14. Carmichael has scored the last 6 points for Illinois State, and he has 14 coming back from that injury. Young can't put it down, so it's a 13-point lead. And Illinois State trying to cut into it with Allen.
Again, the Jays have 10 turnovers, but as we've always said, good shooting covers up a myriad of ills, and they're shooting still 60%. From the field.
Allen with the try. McDermott grabs the board. McDermott and Gibbs often playing a two-man game, and so impressive. Here's Gibbs with the ball.
I'll tell you what he does when he throws the ball to him. He throws it on a straight line.
Echenique can't get it to fall, but the foul is called inside. They'll call it on Hill.
That's what I love about Gibbs. It's a straight line pass. There's no loop to it. There's no flashiness to it. It goes right to the man that's open.
Gibbs with 6 points, 5 rebounds, 8 assists. Echenique misses the free throw. Gregory with 6 points, 9 rebounds. Got that one. Lead back to 14. Carmichael lost the handle, comes up with it, tie up for it. Jump ball, possession arrow says Illinois State. Officials discussing that situation, and they do. Illinois State down by 14, a final chance to make a run with 6:56 on the clock.
Yeah, better start now. know you're down 13 to 7 minutes. You got to pick up 2 points a minute.
Just a tough team to score on tonight. For whatever reason, the shots haven't gone down, especially from three-point range. And we'll harp on it, but 3 for 24 from three-point range.
Yeah, nobody's shooting, so not even for the 1-1.
Wilkins.
This is a
with the handoff to Allen.
Try and create something.
Allen drive. Gets the roll. It's been his night. For Illinois State, Allen with 16 points. That's a career high.
He's not quick. He is very quick. And that football mentality, not afraid to go in, take a hit. Echenique trying to finish it off.
Echenique barrels over Carmichael. Now bodies flying everywhere. And a foul is called.
Echenique.
On Echenique. So it'll be a 1-1 situation on the other end for Illinois State. So that's four on Echenique. Hill is going to go to the line. They call the foul there. So Hill at the stripe shooting a 1-1.
Very good athlete, highly recruited, but just an average free throw shooter, 66%.
Misses the front end, and Gibbs grabs the board.
This is when you'd like to have driven the ball earlier, being a two-shot penalty. You're still going to shoot 1-1 for the next two free throws.
Young plows into Allen, and a foul called on Bryant.
He bumped his knees. But you did see Young try and go right-handed. And right there, able to jump over. Young much prefers to go left and turn that corner.
A couple of quick players right there. Blocking foul called on Allen. Gibbs to McDermott. Blocked away by Wilkins. Allen trying to convert on the other end, throws one up. Hill is there. 10-point game.
Brian Allen and Young challenging each other. Now Hill quicker than Gibbs.
Hill nearly stole it away from Gibbs. Now McDermott gets the handle. That one goes down. McDermott yells out.
And the crowd thought it was a double dribble on Gibbs on the loose ball in front. And then started the dribble to go to the basket. No call there, but 10,000 people were blowing their whistle.
It's a 12-point lead for Creighton, and McDermott at the free throw line. Wilkins comes out of the game to a hand. Eke in there.
How about this, Ray? Doug McDermott growing up in Ames with Harrison Barnes. He's now at North Carolina, won a state championship. He was hidden a bit. I mean, the Central Florida, UNI, Northern Iowa, Creighton, looking at him, and now, as a sophomore, being considered one of the top players in the country.
You look at the player of the year lists from around the country, McDermott isn't out of the top three, really, in any of them. Three knocked down by Cousin. It's back to a 10-point game. Creighton keeping that double-digit advantage. Illinois State hanging around. Young. McDermott. Can't get it to fall. Cousin has it. Cousin trailed. Push. They call it travel. He wanted the push. He got the travel. And it's back to Creighton.
Right there. Crowd says, I'm not sure it's a travel. Did he have control of the ball? And even if he did, might have been a little push along the way.
Now Tim Jankovic is going to walk across the court, wants to have a conversation.
Tim Jankovic, quite a competitor in his playing day at Kansas State. the off guard, Orlando Blackman, a great player. You've got the run out coming down by Cousin. Ah, a little push there by Young. And then the ball comes loose and he pushes it forward. I'm not sure he recontrolled the ball to have it travel. So the crowd saying the officials are 0 for their last three calls.
It's a big crowd here. They have packed it in, and this without the students, Mac.
Yeah.
Students not here.
It's been a good crowd, very good. Well, had the students been here, I think the roof would have come off a couple times. I really got to watch McDermott.
Gibbs driving on Hill and finds an open McDermott.
See, Gibbs just understands to get a shoulder by a man, get a hip by a man, then you can reach around him with the length he has from his arms, and he can dump passes off. Too many people try and pass the ball from their chest.
Carmichael to Allen.
Oh, my goodness. That came from St. Paul, Minnesota.
19 points for Bryant Allen.
Well, we've talked, they needed to cut into the lead 2 points a minute, and they've done that.
Gibbs dribbles off his foot, out of bounds, back to Illinois State. Working on a 9-point deficit now.
Well, what I like, Gibbs has the turnover. The game is coming back tighter. He goes off his foot. Maybe he didn't like what happened. He just goes back and he's playing. He's talking to his teammates about what we're going to get done here defensively.
Cousin, kick out for Hill. It's a 6-point game.
Heat it up, baby. Well, you knew a team that shoots almost 40% from three isn't going to go a whole game making just two.
Young is fouled on his way in.
Oh, they gave continuation.
They'll count it.
I don't know.
Tim Jankovic arguing his case, but they'll count the basket on continuation. And it's 74-66. Creighton in the lead. Back at Illinois State, Creighton with an 8-point lead, 74-66. Illinois State on a 20-10 run from the 9:49 mark. As they announce to the crowd not to throw objects onto the court, that's the reaction that you're hearing. A couple of
well, the fans have not been happy at all with probably four or five of the last open court calls, and the last one being Young with a continuation from the free throw line, and the bucket's good. You can tell Illinois State has really turned up the defense in the second half, because when you look at Creighton, they average about 70% of their baskets have assists. In this game, it is just 30% of Creighton's basket have come from an assist.
Let's take a look at our players of the game, brought to you by State Farm. For auto, home, life, and banking, get to a better state. Find an agent or get a quote at statefarm.com. Grant Gibbs, I mean, 10 assists to go along with 6 points, six rebounds. He's in control. He's not rattled. He finds the open man.
And then, of course, Bryant Allen off the bench. And he's already got 25 minutes in and 19 points, three assists, no turnovers. There you see Grant Gibbs.
31 bench points for Illinois State, 19 of them from Allen. But the three-point play by Young makes it a 9-point game again. And now a foul is called against Creighton, and the Illinois State crowd had some fun with that one.
Yeah, both teams, team foul eight for both of them.
Cousin at the line.
Now you would expect, again, a solid team trying to challenge for a championship. take some time off the clock.
Oh,
I'll bet you he can. Carmichael battle. And here's where Illinois State likes to score on a quick one if they can.
Tim Jankovic calls out a play. Inbound to Allen. He's had the hot hand. 21 points for Brian Allen.
Boy, what energy from the bench. Not only offensively, but defensively. He's trying to keep Antoine Young from the ball. His quicks laterally are just exceedingly exciting to watch. And he just doesn't let Young go to it. Got picked there.
3 minutes to go, 7-point game.
Look out.
Long pass to McDermott. Jones was able to come up with it, and a 10-second call as that one did not cross the timeline.
And now Coach McDermott pleading his case as he thought it was a little quick. Officials get together, checking.
The deflection off Doug McDermott happened right in front of us. I mean, it was right on the line, but what he's asking for is the quickness of the call.
Well, what the Redbirds are trying to do now is create some chaos in the Blue Jays' mind with that pressure. Make them unsure of what they want to do, put it in people's hands that aren't as sure as Grant Gibbs.
I'll tell you what, ever since Johnny Hill came into the game, Illinois State has played better. They've had better energy. He's been able to do some things for them that they didn't get before, as the officials are going to take a look at this 10-second call. Illinois State with the 7-point deficit to make up. Every play at this point at 2:52, ultra important. Our truck will help out the officials.
Well, it looks like the shot clock starts at 33 for some reason.
Let's take a look.
So it starts at 33.
Right.
Not 35. There's no real deflection of control by anybody else. And it does dip right at 24-23.
I'll tell you what, it looked to me like he made it. And that should not be a 10-second call. Looked like he crossed the timeline at 24. We'll see what they say.
Here's a violation.
They'll call it a violation. Boy, I'll tell you, from eyeballing that, and Greg McDermott's going to plead his case.
Well, you've got to get all three parts over. You have to have both feet and the ball on one side of the court before it's determined possession on one side or the other.
Well, they call that a 10-second violation, so Illinois State has a terrific opportunity here.
It could have been 9.9, but Redbird fans don't care right now.
Oh, they're liking that. Here's Allen. He's at the hot hand. Step back. Shot goes down. Brian Allen.
Are you kidding me?
23 points for Allen. 5-point game.
Great things come in small packages. 5'8". Gotta be careful.
The handoff to Young. Gibbs steps in for a shot, had to double pump it, thought maybe he got clipped.
He was looking for a foul. He was holding up, looking for contact from behind. It didn't come. Shot it on the way down, had no legs. 5-point game.
We approach the 2-minute mark. A great finish to wrap up a day of Valley basketball. Hill.
Oh,
goodness.
It's a one possession game. And a timeout is called. This crowd is beside itself at Illinois State.
Coach McDermott comes right over to Grant Gibbs, a team captain before he ever played a game for Creighton, voted by his teammates. McDermott came over, talked to him, and said, hey, just drive it in, get fouled, don't worry about that shot. Right now, Rodney will come in. Three-point specialist, somebody that got a guard, somebody that opens up the middle. But how about when you look at Hill and Brian Allen, what the bench has done, Tom, in this game?
Well, they're finding Allen every time down the floor. 23 points on 9 of 14 shooting, 3 of 6 from three-point range, creating shots, all kinds of shots. You see our game reset, three-point lead for Creighton. Two timeouts apiece, possession arrow favoring the Jays, and 8 fouls apiece, so both teams in the bonus.
When you don't make shots, everything else is magnified because you can't make mistakes. When you do make shots, everything else gets covered up. Oh, they call that foul.
That's going to go against Allen.
Team foul 9, it's 1-1.
It is still 1-1. For the Blue Jays, and it will be 1-1 for Illinois State if they get fouled. Players are trying to slide through, bounce through.
Antoine Young will shoot. 1-1 situation.
Just a 70% free throw shooting.
Illinois State with a chance to cut it to 1 or tie. Cousin. Echenique rips down the rebound.
You felt all the oxygen go out of everybody at once.
Young guarded by Allen.
Get a stop here. Make sure there's no easy penetration, so you don't have to foul.
McDermott on Ike with the basket.
What footwork? Spins in, pivots one way, comes back the other. Now Illinois State has to get a good shot or run it right at the rim. Just drive it to the rim. Creighton's not going to foul you.
Allen, a long three.
Or take a three.
Brian Allen with 26 points. Everything he shoots turns to gold. The NBC on ESPN3 is brought to you by State Farm. For auto, home, life, and banking, get to a better state. By Emerson, the proud presenting partner of the Larry Bird Trophy. Emerson, consider it solved. The farmer-owned Prairie Farms family of dairies. Prairie Farms, Highland and Roberts. Farm fresh quality from our family to yours. By Cardinal Glennon Children's Medical Center, where our love for kids just keeps on growing. And by the Return the Favor Charity Stripe campaign. Visit mbcsports.com/charitystripe to return the favor to our military. They're having fun at Redbird Arena as Illinois State has chopped into this lead, possession after possession, and cuts it to 2. Creighton basketball, 2 ticks under a minute.
First 32 minutes have all been Creighton. The last 7 minutes have all been Illinois State. 2 teams really going at it. Pressure.
Near turnover as Gibbs is able to hang on to it.
You can just stop him. You don't have to foul him.
And Hill does do that. He fouls Gibbs.
A smart veteran move. Gibbs turned his shoulder that time into the defender rather than to go by the defender. Make the official make the call.
Hill, the freshman, has been a big part of this turnaround for Illinois State. Didn't even play in the first half. Last 6 minutes, 7 points. He's been good defensively. He's been able to create some deflections, create a little havoc, change the game. But Gibbs misses the free throw. He was fouled by Hill. 2-point lead for Creighton. That's a big miss.
77% free throw shooting. He gets to shoot 2. But remember, Illinois State, if they get fouled, it's still 1-1 for them. A lot more pressure.
3-point game.
Now, I would drive it right at the rim. Creighton's not going to foul you. Go right to the rim. You don't need the three.
And they don't get it.
Now you foul. Now it goes to 4 points or 5 points in a two-possession game.
Gibbs with the ball, and Hill gets it, and then a little extra push, and they're going to call a technical foul on Hill with a second push. And Gibbs doesn't like it. They'll have to separate the two teams right in front of us. Gibbs and Hill have words.
They're going to throw Hill out.
They're going to throw him out of the game. He gave him a little extra push.
Because you still had a heck of a game. Potentially, you still had a one possession game. But there's a bump there. And just a push in the stomach. That gets you the tee.
It's going to get it. I mean, look, this is heat of the moment stuff, but you can't do it. I mean, he's fallen out of bounds. You can't push the guy.
You've already fouled him. This would be a crime to have this end up with technicals at the end and taking the game away from the kids who both sides played so hard. Both teams well prepared. And, of course, a terrific crowd tonight. Redbird Arena and Hill, as you indicated, brought them back into this game. And as you say, the competitive spirit is there, but you have to know when not to do certain things. You know, they came up with that elbow swinging rule for the same thing, that they just didn't want players using their elbows to swing and accidentally hit someone. You just don't do it anymore. So we could have as many as four fouls if they tossed him.
Well, we'll see how they sort this out, but clearly the extra push from Hill uncalled for, and thus there was a technical foul called, and he's been ejected from the game. So we'll see what they end up doing in terms of free throws. Tim Jankovic drops his clipboard to walk over to have a chat. And it would be a shame to have it end in that fashion, although we're far from an ending here with a 3-point lead for Creighton, 24.4 on the clock. Creighton's had some trouble making free throws and closing this out.
Well, the explanation is coming that I gave him one, then either he said something or gave another argument. It was both Gibbs and Hill chatting with each other for a moment.
Creighton once led this game by 18 points. Illinois State has climbed back, actually cut it to two at 77-75, and Creighton by three. Here's the play we're talking about. There's the foul, and then the extra. Johnny Hill whistled for that. He's been ejected from the game. And we'll get an explanation from the officials as to what exactly is going to take place in terms of these two teams. There was a situation in which Hill pushed Gibbs into the table here. They had to sort it out, talk it over. Mac McCausland, what did the officials tell you?
Well, we have got a personal foul that took place first. Then that was on Hill. Then we have a dead ball technical foul on Hill. Then after that, we have two fouls for jawing each other, Gibbs and Hill. Those will offset each other. What will happen is they'll go to the free throw line to shoot just the two technical fouls, and then it'll be Blue Jays ball. And Hill has to leave the arena. Thank the officials for coming over. Helping us clarify it all.
Hill, yes, absolutely. And Hill walks through the tunnel. Applause from the Illinois State fans as he leaves, and really did play a strong second half. Now they're explaining what we just explained to you to the crowd here at Illinois State. Gibbs is going to get the free throws. Chance to increase this Blue Jays lead. It's It's now a 5-point lead. It's 80-75. So now McDermott is going to get the technical.
That was the personal foul.
Right.
Yes. Now these are the technical, and only the two of those shots.
But it's that's a big miss there.
Two possession game.
So is that.
Still a chance, but you better get a steal, double team, here in the first 5 or 6 seconds. Maybe even try to get it right away.
Have to get a steal. They look for it. Gibbs has trouble, and he has to call a timeout.
And now each team down to one timeout left.
Creighton by 5 in what has been a wild final minute here in Normal. Anything but normal.
Yeah, this is abnormal Illinois right now. Creighton's going to have to be careful of. There's quickness on the court defending them. To get away from quickness, you like to set screens, but as you do it, you have a tendency you like to push off and separate. Now, these officials have been heightened with their antenna. They will look for and see what kind of contact is taking place. So Creighton's going to have to be very careful about getting a push off while they're trying to get open.
In case you're curious, these two teams will meet again on February 1st in Omaha.
Buy your tickets now, if there's any left.
Should be a good one.
Now, Moore is there quickly.
Young is fouled. He goes to the free throw line. Again, this is a
smart play.
Two-shot foul.
Yep. Smart play, do it right away. Yeah. Two-shot foul. But you've got to drive. You can drive it right away. But you're going to need a three at some point. So if they leave you open as you come to the top of the key, go ahead and take that. Echenique probably in for Raggi. That's a big in for the shooter. And now Echenique and McDermott just go back. No reason to go for an offensive rebound. Get a silly foul coming over somebody's back. And Young may have just put a dagger in there. 6 points.
Moore dribbles up. Allen for three.
No.
He's making everything. Everything he shoots. That's 29 points for Brian Allen. His previous career high was 14.
My goodness gracious. That's incredible.
And it's been basically from the same spot. Yeah, he loves that left wing. It's a 4-point game, and Creighton still with a heavy advantage here.
Well, again, it's back to steal the ball and see if you can go ahead and drive it. What you want to do, if you can get a steal, I think still drive it. Don't take the three yet. Carmichael setting that pick right here.
Allen.
Allen. How about a floater? How about a left-handed corner shot? How about just off the glass? I mean, this guy is a circus in himself. Deep.
That's
medium range. Oh. Out of bounds play right there. Turn the corner, step back.
That's my favorite.
Yeah, the ball wasn't even in the TV set. Look at this.
Oh.
And by the way, we'll just shoot one more.
Oh, why not?
Terrific job.
Illinois State
from St. Louis.
Absolutely, from Maplewood. Illinois State uses its final timeout. Possession arrow favoring Creighton. Timeout in Greg McDermott's pocket.
Definitely get the ball. McDermott has size. They could throw it to him. Just alley-oop it to him.
Full court pressure from Illinois State, and a foul is called right in front of the inbounds. So they call that on Cousin. And a two-shot situation for Creighton. Still a lot of time, but with a 6-point game potentially, you got to start thinking about threes and not driving.
Right. If he just makes one, I'd still drive it and try, because they're going to give you the two. At least get that, the clock stops, and you can set up your defense. If you put up the three, ball gets loose, bounces around, time goes off the clock. Echenique back in. And of course, he'll be there to defend the net. He's put in there as a tall goalie at this point.
They'll drop McDermott back as well. Now they...
Oh, time did not go off the clock, so they can't make the substitution.
Echenique cannot return to the floor since the clock did not run. He came out of the game. The clock did not
so
start.
Echenique so has to take a seat. They'll drop McDermott back, as well as Rogge, we would assume. The big men back. Managa at the free throw line. They also drop Gibbs back. Managa makes the free throw. It's a 6-point game.
Now Nick Moore just ought to take it as far as he can.
They're going to try to find Allen. Shot up, and this one won't go down. Gibbs with the rebound. Fouled by Ikey. 7.3 on the clock.
I'll tell you, he's got a terrific now. Fans are throwing rubber balls onto the court.
Now another mini basketball goes onto the court.
That is a technical
and they,
foul.
As they warned Illinois State, that would be a technical foul if they did it again. And a technical has been called against Illinois State for an object going onto the court.
And as you indicated, there was no question the crowd was warned, talked to, but as an Illinois State fan, you don't like to see this by one of your people. You certainly want to show good sportsmanship. This has been a terrific game up until the last minute of play when we had the technical and the altercation with Hill and Gibbs. Terrific basketball game, great flow, players making plays, coaches allowing the players to do it.
It's a solid win for Creighton on the road. You knew it was going to be a battle. You knew it was going to be a fight. And I'll tell you, we'll be talking about this leading into the February 1st game in Omaha. And if these two end up meeting each other in Arch Madness, yep, this game will be discussed. Oh.
This will be one of the better games in the Valley this year, no question. It's got a lot of sidebars, a lot of great stories. Brian Allen, you know, do you leave him on the bench? Do you start him now? Because basically the Redbirds have said, hey, we have six starters. I hate to tell you, you got 6.5 now.
He scores 29 points. Moore's three off the mark. And Creighton, the 21st ranked team of the nation, comes away with a 9-point victory at Illinois State. 87-78 our final here on the MVC on ESPN3. We're glad you were with us for this matchup in Normal, Illinois. For my partner, Mac McCausland, I'm Tom Ackerman. Thanks for joining us on the MVC on ESPN3.